Hey guys, in this clip, I'm going to show you an efficient way to create a highly accurate transcript of your finished video sequence. Convert that to an SRT file format, and then use that SRT to generate the subtitles for your video. I'm going to show you how to leverage resources available online, which are powered by artificial intelligence. I'll show you how to trial those for free and what you can get even within the most basic free account. And if you agree with me that they do offer really exciting possibilities to improve your workflow, they do offer low-cost membership options. Those AI resources really are going to save a huge amount of time and effort. First, they're going to convert the speech to text to save you writing everything out. Later on, they're going to match the transcript to the source file, so everything's in sync and your captions will appear exactly when they should do. Let's be clear though, this isn't a magic bullet solution. You're still going to need to commit time and effort to get the results you want, especially at the proofreading stage. However, I do know for a fact that this workflow, for me at least, has been far more efficient than what I was doing before. So I'm fairly confident it could help a lot of you out there. Now, when I produce one of these workflow videos, I like to think about it. So this is going to be a comprehensive in-depth clip. However, if you're in a rush, I have put timestamps in the description. I should clarify that in my case, I rarely write and then follow a full script for my videos. I may have a partial script for sections that I'll do to camera, but for the voiceover stuff that I do at my desk, that's rarely the case. My point is, if you already have written a script and have followed it during filming, then of course you do have a transcript of your video. The first part of the workflow that I'm going to walk you through is how to create a transcript when you don't have one. You've already got one, so you can skip ahead to the section about proofreading, which you're going to need to do before you match the transcript to the source file and create the SRT. So are we talking about subtitles or captions? Well, it can be a bit confusing because there is an incredible amount of overlap between the two. It's easier to understand the difference if you think about a television context. Subtitles essentially assumed the viewer could hear what was coming through the television set. So subtitles were essentially used to translate foreign languages within programming content. Captions, or closed captions on the other hand, were developed for those with hearing impairment. So they transcribed all the dialogue that is spoken regardless of the language and also included additional information such as sound effects and music. Today, in a social media context, with so many people watching content mute, the terms are much more interchangeable. In fact, if you look at YouTube at the little icon that allows you to switch on and off the function during the clips, it's actually called subtitles/closed captions. The point is, let's not get too hung up about the terms. For the purposes of this video, if I say captions, it can stand for subtitles and vice versa. What is important though, is that you must add them to your videos. The process would be worthwhile if only for the fact that most people are watching your content mute, certainly in the first instance. But if you add on top of that the fact that a lot of people perhaps will be exposed to your content for whom your language is their second language and it becomes a must. And then of course there are the people who are hearing impaired. They'll really appreciate the fact that you've gone to the effort of making captions for your video content. And there's another reason still. Adding captions to your video content gives the likes of Google and YouTube an additional source of searchable data, which in turn improves your SEO and could boost the chances of your video being watched, which is what it's all about, right? But here's the thing, those captions need to be accurate. If they're not, not only will you not benefit potentially from that search boost, but your content could be penalized if it's associated with shoddy metadata. So let's go about making accurate video subtitles. Until recently, this is how I'd go about making subtitles. So I just filmed a very quick piece to camera on my mobile phone, and then I thought, well, why not? I've got a sequence in Premiere, 4.5 minutes, ready to go. I'll go to the captions options in Premiere, and I'll select open captions from the drop-down list. This gives me the most flexibility to format the captions exactly the way I want in terms of font and spacing. Next, I'm going to playback the sequence. So I just filmed a very quick piece, stopping at natural pauses and also ensuring that any given chunk of subtitles don't exceed the desired width. It's a time-consuming process. I'm not a touch typist. I'm fairly competent, but it is time-consuming. I think it's also worth noting here that the quality of the transcription that is generated here by a human being is, of course, entirely down to that person. Anybody can make spelling mistakes, but also people can have a tendency to mishear what is actually being spoken, and all of that can generate inaccurate transcripts. The point is, even though human beings are doing it and spending a lot of time on it, it's not infallible. Mistakes do creep in. It's worth bearing in mind when you compare it to the automated approach later. I've worked at quite a few production companies and seen other people approach this. And from my observation, I'd say this is a fairly standard approach to the workflow. Personally, I didn't know until recently that you could export the captions as a separate sidecar file. When I've produced clips for clients, in the vast majority of cases, the deliverable has been to provide a version with subtitles and one without. The client then makes the decision about where they publish the different versions. And once I'd completed the process and transcribed the entire sequence to generate all the captions, when it came to export, I would export two different versions of the clip, one with captions or subtitles burnt in, completely visible on screen, and one version without. To do that, I'd simply toggle the visibility of the subtitle layer in the timeline. Now I think the better option is to create an SRT file outside of Premiere. So what is an SRT file? Well, it's simply a plain text file with a very precise format. This number represents the subtitle block as it will appear chronologically in the timeline. This is the exact subtitle text, and these are the time codes for the duration of the subtitle. And it's worth noting that those are defined right down to the millisecond. Now, because this is just a plain text file, there's nothing whatsoever stopping you creating manually an SRT file. Nothing except the fact it is incredibly laborious. You'd need to write all the time codes down to the millisecond and follow this exact format. It's absolutely no surprise then that there is a big market for paid services offering to create subtitles for you. And if you've got a budget for that, more power to you. Rev.com seems to get a lot of traction with YouTube influencers. I've never used them, so can offer no comment on their quality. But it's clear that costs could add up quickly. I noticed in this one case study, the YouTuber has paid for over 5,000 minutes of video to be captioned, which even at $1 a minute is still $5,000 spent on subtitles, which is something I can't imagine doing. Something else to consider would be utilizing the captions that YouTube itself creates automatically for every video you upload, certainly in English. The critical thing to remember about these automatic YouTube captions is that they are very inaccurate. Now, if you're anything like me, in your own home, the subtitles as provided are littered with punctuation mistakes and mistranscribed words. Within YouTube Studio, you do have a mechanism with which to edit the captions, and I'd always recommend doing that. However, my problem with this is I find that interface incredibly clunky and awkward to use. You've also got to remember that to make use of this function, you need to upload a video to YouTube. You need to have a YouTube account and a channel. So maybe not everybody does. Or also, perhaps you're working on a video that you have no intention of posting on YouTube. I guess you could upload and keep the video private, but it all starts to get a little bit complicated. For all these reasons, I now prefer to create an accurate SRT file before the upload stage. If the clip's going onto YouTube, I can attach the file at the upload stage, or I can simply import it into Premiere and then use that to create the captions immediately with no extra work. So let's make use of some free artificial intelligence available online to make the process faster and easier. The first thing to do is to create an audio export of your final sequence. I'm going to be working in Premiere, but you will be able to do this in whatever editing platform you are working in. Avid, Final Cut Pro, DaVinci Resolve, they can all do this, no problem. Your sequence really should be locked down at this stage. In other words, you're not going to make any changes. You're trying to create a transcript that's synchronized to your sequence. So if you change the sequence, obviously it won't match. For this particular audio export, all that matters is what is being said, the dialogue. So you should, if at all possible, mute any audio tracks with music on. Adjust your audio as required before export to provide as clear a dialogue source as possible for the AI to work on. The more intelligible the dialogue, the more accurate the results you can expect back. So in this particular example, the sequence is over 14 minutes long and it's pretty much all dialogue. I'd guess it would take me a couple of hours just plodding through those 14 minutes of dialogue, creating the captions within Premiere. So let's try the better way. So first I'll create the audio export. Now I'm choosing an MP3 format. The first time I tried it, I did export as WAV, which is a higher quality. But then I came across a problem with the first piece of artificial intelligence because the file size was too big. So MP3 is absolutely fine for this. Watson is IBM's artificial intelligence system. You can access the speech-to-text demo free online. You can see on screen that I'd crashed the demo with that WAV file, which was too large. But the MP3 version was absolutely fine. You just upload the file and then Watson begins to play it out and transcribe it in real time. And the transcription appears in the box that you can see. So incredibly straightforward. You simply arrive at the website, have a file ready to upload, and you could initiate that transcription from speech to text within seconds. Now it's worth mentioning here that IBM make a point of stating on the webpage that you should not upload any audio that includes personal data. And that, of course, should apply to all the other pieces of AI that we'll be looking at. You need to take a view on whether you're comfortable uploading any audio to any of these platforms. If there's anything confidential, anything contentious, anything truly personal in nature, obviously don't do it. As far as the limitations go for this IBM Watson demo, as discussed, there is an upper limit for file size. In terms of time duration, I'm not sure. All I do know for certain is that this 14-minute MP3 file was no problem at all for it. So once I started the playback and the automated transcription began, I didn't do anything else. I actually just sat there and waited. But obviously you could do what you like. You could be getting on with something else. The point is, you're not spending time on this at this stage. You're just letting the AI do the legwork. So about a quarter of an hour later, the transcription was complete. And it really does give you an idea of how many words can be spoken in 13 and a bit minutes. It's a mass of unformatted plain text, and I simply copied it and pasted it into a Google Doc. We'll return to it later. I'll be completely honest and say that before starting my research into this project, I'd never heard of Otter. Then again, I'd never looked into transcription by AI, which is what Otter does. And I think within the sector, they are very highly regarded. Without wishing to jump ahead too much, I do think that this entire project was worthwhile for me, simply because I've now discovered Otter and I'm very impressed. The free account that they provide is generous. It will allow you to have up to 600 minutes transcribed per month. However, there is one limitation you need to be aware of. With the free plan, you can only import, in other words, upload, three different files. Each one of those files can be up to 40 minutes in length. Once you've uploaded your three files, that's your free import allocation used up. You can't bring any more into Otter. So I suggest if you try this, make the most of it by importing long sequences, not 2-minute edits. You may well have a lot of free monthly minutes left, and I think you can make use of those still within the interface. There's a record function, so I believe you can dictate straight into Otter. Or I believe some people will use Otter to create transcripts of meetings or presentations as they take place. In and of itself, that's a useful function to have, but as far as this particular project goes, where we're trying to automate as much as possible the caption workflow, it doesn't help us out. We need to be able to import those audio exports from our project. To do that, create a free account, log in, and then select the import audio/video option. In my case, the audio export I created earlier, of course. That will begin to upload. You can, of course, transcribe a video file that includes dialogue, not just an audio file. The reason I choose to export an audio file from my video sequence is that it will create a file that's smaller and easier to work with, upload, etc. If you do prefer to export a video file for transcription, then you'd still need to follow the procedures to ensure that the audio, the dialogue, is as clear as possible, and remove any music if you can. So once the file has imported successfully, you can initiate the actual transcription by AI. And because the process is entirely automated, you are completely free to leave it alone at this stage and go and spend your time elsewhere. Or if you're curious, you can step into the transcription and look at the document as it is being created and revealed in stages. Or you can choose to have an email notification sent to you when it's completed. I just waited because I was curious how long it would take to complete the processing. In the end, this 13 minute plus sequence took less than 8 minutes to process, which I thought was pretty impressive. So opening up the completed transcript reveals that Otter's artificial intelligence has assigned my voice characteristics as speaker one. Now in this particular case, there is only me speaking throughout the entire clip, so there is only one speaker. But obviously if there were more, then a number of different speakers would be identified and created. The completed transcript is searchable and Otter.ai has already identified keywords. I think that's a nice touch and it could be very useful. Now, if you sign up for Otter's premium plan, at this stage, you can export an SRT directly. A lot of people already do that and I could well join them in the near future. But for now, let me show you how to do this for free. I'm going to export the transcript as a plain text file. To do this, I'm going to choose the export text option and then deselect any formatting options available. And then I copy and paste the plain text and put it into a Google Doc, just as I did with the IBM Watson demo version transcript. Because trying to work and edit within a native plain text app, such as Notepad, is a bit of a pain, to be honest. For example, the text doesn't wrap particularly easily. I'm going to carefully proofread, correct as required, so it's ready to be the basis of the SRT. However, I'm only going to bother with one of the two. The one which has come back from the AI and is most accurate. And with the two documents side by side, it really is night and day in that respect. The accuracy of the transcription produced by Otter is far superior to the accuracy of the transcription produced by IBM Watson Demo. Let me show you what I mean with the first 30 seconds of the transcribed sequence. Hey guys, in this clip, I'm going to show you how to use this camera, the JVC GY LS300, to stream directly into YouTube. Once you've set it up, you'll be able to stream directly just using this. No external hardware, no capture cards, no laptops required, nothing whatsoever apart from the camera, because this particular camera, which happens to be a great little camera in my opinion, has the encoding functionality built directly inside of it. Hey guys, in this clip, I'm going to show you how to use this camera, the JVC GY LS300, to stream directly into YouTube. Once you've set it up, you'll be able to stream directly just using this. No external hardware, no capture cards, no laptops required, nothing whatsoever apart from the camera, because this particular camera, which happens to be a great little camera in my opinion, has the encoding functionality built directly inside of it. I did have a look on the website to find some sort of official statistic representing how accurate Otter.ai is claimed to be. I couldn't find that from the actual company. I could find a few testimonials which put it between 85 and 95% accuracy, and that seems about right to me. Not only was the accuracy of Otter's transcription impressive, but I also think it did a great job of accurately punctuating. Of course, it wasn't perfect, but it has provided a fantastic foundation for the next step of the workflow, the stage where we do need to commit some time and effort to get the very best results. So thanks to Otter.ai, we do have a very good transcript to start with. However, there are errors. So I'm going to open the Google Doc with the Otter transcript and also open the audio file used to create that transcript. And I'm simply going to play back that audio file in short sections. Hey guys, in this clip, I'm going to show you how to use this camera, the JVC GY LS300, to stream. And all I'll do is read along with the transcript and look for any mistakes. This could range from words which have been completely omitted or words which have been mistranscribed by Otter.ai. I'll add punctuation as required, or it could simply be words, typically proper nouns, which require capitalization. Now, there's no getting around the fact that this will take time. I spent about 30 minutes to correct this 13 minute plus sequence. It's worth bearing in mind, I think, a couple of things. First, so far, we've spent so little time getting to this stage. Otter.ai has done the hard work of actually typing out the dialogue. The second point is that because Otter.ai's transcript was accurate, as we say, maybe 90% accurate, really, there is not that much to do at this stage. You really do reap the benefit of that accurate transcription in the first instance. So it's just relatively small things that you're picking up on. By contrast, if I was trying to correct the transcript produced by IBM Watson Demo, then I'd obviously need to spend a lot more time because there were far more errors and mistranscribed words. And finally, whether that's a human being or another form of AI creating the transcript, there will always be mistakes in there. And so you do need to just accept that there will be a point where you need to really carefully go through and proofread if you really care about making accurate subtitles. Descript is the software we're going to use to take the accurate transcript we've now created and convert it to a fully formatted SRT file, including, of course, those time codes to the millisecond, which will ensure the captions appear synced to the video. Descript is a competitor to Otter.ai, and just like Otter, there is a free plan which we're going to make the most of. From looking around the website and just reading a little of the information provided, it does appear there is an awful lot in terms of functionality available from Descript. In all fairness, I haven't had a chance to investigate that functionality. I have not used Descript to transcribe, so I can't offer any insight whatsoever to the accuracy of the automated transcription service. However, it's worth noting that as well as the automated transcription service, Descript offer what they call the white glove transcription service, which is in effect humans transcribing it for maximum accuracy. Obviously, you pay more for this. But the reason we're including Descript within this workflow is simply this. If you sign up for a free account, you can make use of the fact that Descript will sync a completed transcript to a given audio or video source file. And once that sync's complete, you can export that as an SRT file. And all of that is automated and free. So let's have a look how to do it. So after you've set up your free account, you need to install the desktop app, which is going to be the interface for your work in Descript. Open up the desktop app and create a new project. Use the Choose File button to navigate to and import the source file. In my case, the audio file exported from Premiere. When the source file has been imported, in the bottom left of the screen, you'll see your options for transcribing that file. You need to put it onto Import Transcript. When you've changed that selection, hit the Transcribe button and another small window will open up. Into this window, you're going to copy and paste the entire transcript you've already proofread and edited. And as soon as it becomes available, you simply hit the sync button. And that's it. Descript is now going to begin matching the transcript you provided with the source file. Once again, it's worth stressing that you don't need to do anything. This is fully automated. Artificial intelligence is doing the work. The only thing I didn't like was that the progress bar doesn't seem to update. It just stays at 0% until it's finished. But that really is an absolutely minor point. It's no big deal at all. And of course, you don't have to stay looking at the progress anyway. You can do whatever you like with your time. Once again, an email notification will be sent to you when the process is finished. In this case, the nearly 14-minute sequence took less than 3 minutes, I think, to sync, which is very, very impressive. And when the processing is complete, you're going to have a transcript which is perfectly in sync with the source file. And that is fairly awesome. Hey guys, in this clip, I'm going to show you how to use this camera, the JVC GY LS300, to stream directly into YouTube. Once you've set it up, you'll be able to stream directly just using this. No external hardware, no capture cards, no laptops required, nothing whatsoever apart from the camera, because this particular camera, which happens to be a great little camera in my opinion, has the encoding functionality built directly inside of it. Now, just hit the share button. Choose export. And then subtitles. SRT will be available as the format option. And notice that there is a maximum number of characters per line, and that's a value you can change. As I understand it, 32 characters, including spaces, is the preferred maximum length for the SRT format, although there is a bit of flexibility, it seems. Maximum number of lines per card must be left at 2. Then you're simply going to export your SRT file. And once it's exported, I'm going to open it up. So here it is, our completed SRT file. The transcript we know all about because we've gone through it and we're happy with the accuracy. And now Descript has formatted it so it conforms to SRT requirements, including those elusive time codes down to the millisecond. And to show just how powerful that SRT file is, I'm going to import it straight back into Premiere, back into the project with our source sequence that we used for the original audio export. And I'll just drop the SRT onto the top layer. Hey guys, in this clip, I'm going to show you how to use this camera, the JVC GY LS300, to stream directly into YouTube. Once you've set it up, you'll be able to stream directly just using this, no external hardware. And those are accurate captions, perfectly in sync with the video. It's always better to be at a lower resolution but stable than set the camera for a higher resolution and risk breaking up. And of course, you do not have to bring it back into Premiere. It's completely self-contained. It has both the text for the transcript and the timecode data included within its own file. So if you wish, you can simply wait until the YouTube upload stage and attach the SRT file at that point. We've done what we set out to do, create an SRT file to produce our video captions with an accurate transcript and using AI as much as possible to take as much of the burden away from us. Let's recap how we did it. When your sequence is complete, create an audio or video export of the sequence. I prefer creating an audio version as it's more lightweight and easier to upload. The key thing is you must ensure your audio dialogue is as clear as possible. That means muting any music tracks if you can, and optimizing the audio levels so they're nice and clear. After creating a free account in Otter.ai, import the audio or video file, then initiate the transcription using Otter's artificial intelligence processing. When the transcription is complete, export that as a plain text file. Put the plain text file into something like Google Docs, where you can proofread. Even though Otter.ai's transcript is highly accurate, there will be errors, words omitted, mistakes. You just need to spend time looking for them and correcting them at this stage. When that's done, and assuming you've created your free account in Descript, start a new project, import the source file, and then import the completed transcript you've just proofread. Use the sync functionality offered by your free Descript account to match the completed transcript to the source file. Once that automated process is complete, you can export the final SRT file. You can now bring that straight back into Premiere to create the captions instantly, or you can simply choose to attach that SRT file at the YouTube upload stage. Now, before I go any further, I wanted to say a thank you to David, who runs a channel called Freelancer Insights. When I set out looking for information and suggestions and ideas for how I could kind of improve my workflow, some of the only useful clips I found were produced by him. I'll leave a link to his channel in the description. He seems to be quite a specialist in this sort of area. So if you're at all interested in this topic, I suggest you look at his channel. So what did I learn from all this? Well, let's take it from the beginning. IBM Watson, the demo version. I really wanted to include that because I wanted some sort of baseline. And I do appreciate that IBM Watson is involved in it as an artificial intelligence kind of resource, or is involved in a huge amount of things that go beyond transcription works. My only touching upon IBM Watson has been in the demo version for transcription. I've got to say, I have not been that impressed. I was not that impressed. Obviously, the sample size has been quite small, but it was exactly the same file as transcribed by Otter. An IBM Watson demo just was quite clearly inferior. I can't see a reason to use that going forward if you've got to do so much work to correct the transcription and errors that it's going to generate. So moving on to Otter.ai, I mean, that was absolutely fantastic. Just using it, the interface, the ease of use was all great. I just found it a very pleasurable experience in that sense. But of course, the crown jewel is simply the fact that the quality of the automated transcription was absolutely first rate. I've obviously used it in some other sequences since. And again, it's just a very, very high quality, accurate transcript that you receive. In and of itself, that's a game changer.
As discussed, with the free basic plan, you can import three files and see for yourself.
I'm very, very close to signing on for the upgraded paid membership. From that point, if I can export the SRT file directly from Otter, it's a one-stop shop. So that just leaves Descript. We're in the situation that obviously I was only bringing into Descript a finalized transcript, which I'd already created elsewhere and I'd already gone through. I have not been able to investigate how good the automated transcription is within Descript.
Of course, if you already have an accurate transcript, whether created in Otter, elsewhere, or if you followed a written script during filming, you won't need to make use of the transcription service. You just want to sync the transcript to the source sequence.
As it is, the fact that you can use Descript within its free basic account to sync the transcript you're preparing elsewhere is fantastic. It's absolutely a wonderful gift to make the most of. So if you did find this clip useful, don't be afraid of smashing that like button right now. And of course, any questions, any further comments or thoughts, you can put in the comments field below. If I've overlooked something, if you've got a suggestion for how you can do this better, especially if there's a free resource out there that I've never heard about, please do let me know. This clip's been about a better approach to creating captions and videos for your subtitles. If you'd like to take a better approach to filming yourself, some sort of piece to camera, a vlog, a video testimonial, a bit like this, just you looking straight down that lens, delivering your lines. Take a look at the clip that's on screen right now, where I go in depth, not only about technical considerations and equipment, but also a mental approach to give yourself the best chance of success as you step in front of the lens and deliver your lines. And if you're just interested in creating better content, consider subscribing, because that's what this channel is all about.